ஆமாம், எல்லாம் தெரிஞ்சவங்க தான்டா, ஜாலியாக ஃப்ரீயாக பேசலாம்டா.
எக்ஸாக்ட்லி.
Hello everyone. Yeah. We'll get started in a few minutes. No, he's ready. வணக்கம். மெனி ஆஃப் அஸ் ஸ்பீக் தமிழ், ஸோ ஐ தாட் வில் ஸ்டார்ட் வித் அ லிட்டில் பிட் ஆஃப் தமிழ். ஸோ ஐ வோன்ட் டேக் லாங். ஸோ யூஸ்வலி இன் சச் ஈவெண்ட்ஸ் வி ஹாவ் கெஸ்ட் கம்மிங் ஃப்ரம் அவுட் ஆஃப் டவுன், பட் த ஸ்பெஷாலிட்டி ஃபார் டுடே இஸ் வி ஆர் கண்டக்டிங் திஸ் ஈவெண்ட் பீங் த ஹோஸ்ட் ஃப்ரம் அவுட் ஆஃப் டவுன், அண்ட் தட்ஸ் பீன் பாசிபிள் ஓன்லி பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் த குருஸ் ஃபேமிலி அண்ட் ஆர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹியர் இன் நியூ ஜெர்சி, ரைட்? அதர்வைஸ் this is something I was called a crazy lady was trying to do this. But yes, we are here today.
So just one of the reasons why they call her crazy lady, not just that's the only reason.
Yeah, you can.
That's a different story, Viju.
Yeah, yeah. Continue.
hey, this is going to be a cozy event with people probably whom we all know face to face. You know, that's nice because in a way, Lakshmi's way she started, we wanted to have this function where Bindhya grew up and where people saw how Bindhya grew. You know, this is also a welcome to people who are watching this online, specifically to my parents and Lakshmi's parents who are in Chennai who could not be here in person. And of course, our friends and family, primarily in California as well as in India. We have a few in Sweden and some in Bahrain. So we have a crowd which is virtual across the globe, thanks to technology and Justin. So we welcome everybody, both who are here in person as well as who are remote. And then to start off, we would like to welcome to the stage gurus and the entire musician troupe onto the stage, who is going to be the part of this function along with Bindhya.
Guru Shuba Parmar. Guru Swamimalai Suresh. Vocalist Praveen. Vishwanathan sir.
Mridangist.
Vasant Kumar sir. And Durai Srinivasan. I'd now like to invite to the stage our MC for the evening. She's a Shubanjali alumni, Divya Krishnan. And she's a rising junior at the University of Pennsylvania studying mechanical engineering. She completed her Arangetram 4 years ago with Shubanjali here and has been a student of Suba Parma since she was 7. And Divya and Bindhya, they have known each other since Bindhya was in elementary school. They were learning music together and we have been neighbors for years. So it's nice to have somebody from within the school present this event for us. So welcoming Divya.
You want to say hello, everyone?
Party Tata, I'd like to see you. Thank you, Divya.
Of course. Thank you so much, Lakshmi Aunty and Partha Uncle, for the wonderful introduction. On behalf of Shubanjali Performing Arts and the Parthasarathy family, I welcome all of you to the Bharatanatyam Arangetram of Bindhya Parthasarathy. An Arangetram is a milestone for any child learning an art form, and it's the first stepping stone as a performer. This year marks the 30th year of Shubanjali Performing Arts, making this year's Arangetrams monumental for all of the students who performed and the Guru Shubha Parmar and Suresh sir. Before we commence, I just want to remind you kindly of a few housekeeping rules. Kindly move to the front and the center of the auditorium. No food and drinks are allowed inside, and please keep your cell phones on vibrate and no flash photography. We'll begin the program with a quick introduction on Arangetrams and the classical art form itself. Now, what is an Arangetram? Arangetram is the debut performance of any dancer. After years of classical training and this past year filled with hours of rigorous, dedicated training, this day has finally arrived for Bindhya. The Arangetram is known as the graduation event for a dancer. The word Aranga means stage, and Etram means rising or climbing. The word Arangetram is from the Tamil language and means ascending the stage by a dancer on the completion of formal training. To perform an Arangetram is an old tradition, which marks the pathway for a dancer to then perform alone or be able to be given training to other dancers. Bindhya will present a margam, which is a collection of several items which will showcase all of the components of Bharatanatyam. Bharatanatyam itself is a classical dance form of South India and is said to be originated in Tamil Nadu. The name Bharatanatyam is derived from three basic concepts of bhava, raga, and tala. Bhava, which means emotion, raga means music or melody, and tala, which means rhythm. Bharatanatyam has three distinct elements to it. Nritta, which are the rhythmic dance movements, Natya, which is dance with a dramatic aspect, and Nritya, which is a combination of Nritta and Natya. Today, we can witness Bindhya with her debut performance illustrating this art form and all three distinct elements. On behalf of Bindhya's parents and the teachers Srimati Shubha Parmar and Sri Swamimalai K. Suresh, and on my own personal behalf, I would like to welcome all of you for the Arangetram of Bindhya Parthasarathy. All of you have taken your valuable time this summer to come and grace this occasion. I welcome all of you to participate and cheer Bindhya on during her performance and progress throughout this performance. We will begin this wonderful evening by a prayer song by our wonderful team of musicians.
Tadanananara rananananananara rananananananara Rana, 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 Rana no, 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 Rana 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 na na Rana na 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 கருணா சிந்தும் ஞானதம் சாந்த ரூபினம் புராணம் Shankaram, Oka Shankaram, Shankaram, Shankaram. Gajavadana karuna sadana, Gajavadana karuna sadana, Gajavadana karuna sadana, Shri Gajavadana karuna sadana. Oh,
What an auspicious way to start the performance. Let's hear it one more time for the orchestra. We begin this dance performance with the Pushpanjali. Pushpanjali is derived from two Sanskrit words, pushpam, meaning flower, and anjali, meaning offering with folded hands, giving the meaning, the offering of flowers with folded hands. During a Pushpanjali, the dancer offers flowers to the gods and seeks the blessings from the Lord Nataraja, guru, musicians, and the audience. This piece is used as an invocatory item in the Bharatanatyam repertoire. Bindhya's Pushpanjali is a traditional composition in Adi Talam and Ragam Hamsatvani.
Thank you.
beautiful start to this Arangetram. Bindhya lit up this stage with that Pushpanjali. Let's hear it one more time. On stage now, we will now invite Priya Gohil, a passionate dancer, proud alumna, and the 112th graduate of Shubanjali. Her Bharatanatyam dance journey began at the early age of 7, and her Arangetram last year marked a similar transformative period in her life. Priya will help depict the essence of these rich stories through her expressions and movements. The next piece in this repertoire is a kirtanam named Om Shakti, a beautiful kirtanam by Sri Subramanya Bhardiyar in Adi Talam, Ragamalika, invokes the blessings of Ganesha, Shakti, Muruga, Saraswati, Krishna, and Lakshmi. With the refrain, Om Shakti Om, the poet describes Shakti as the embodiment of the ultimate consciousness. Om, the eternal source, sound, vibration of creation, and Shakti, meaning energy or power. Thus, Shakti is the feminine aspect of the divine and can be used to refer to any goddess. Bindhya invokes the blessings of several gods through this beautiful kirtanam. First, we will offer prayers to Lord Ganesha, who has a radiant face, as he will remove all of our obstacles. Next, we will offer our prayers to Parashakti, the divine feminine energy, and seek her blessings, the one who bestows strength and prosperity among noble warriors. We will then praise Lord Kartikeya, also known as Lord Muruga, the gallant deity who removes all obstacles on his glorious peacock. We celebrate his victories with joy. We will offer our devotion then to Goddess Saraswati, who sits on a lotus, and we will witness the enchanting dances of Lord Krishna, who plays divine music with his flute. Lastly, we will admire the six-faced Lord Subramanya to eliminate all obstacles. Please enjoy Bindhya's Om Shakti Kirtanam.
Shakti, Om Shakti, Om Parashakti, Om Shakti, Om Shakti, Om. Yeah.
divine artistic flow depicting so many different forms of Shakti. Bindhya's expressions were truly beautiful. This next song is a Jatiswaram. A Jatiswaram, as the term suggests, is a combination of Jati and Swara patterns. A Jatiswaram is a pure dance presentation, devoid of any abhinaya, in which intricate sequences are fused with repetitive musical notes. The dance deals with the execution of adavus, which are the basic steps, and mudras, which are hand movements, combined in definite groups. A Jatiswaram brings out three aspects of the dance: unity of music, rhythm, and movements. A Jatiswaram can have many passages varying in length, usually in increasing fashion. Today's Jatiswaram is a traditional composition in Adi Talam. This is a pure nritta item in which Bindhya will showcase her knowledge of rhythm through intricate footwork, keeping in beat with the mridangist in this. Please enjoy the Jatiswaram in Ragam Yadukula Kambodhi.
Okay. Thank you.
Such an energetic performance, displaying Bindhya's footwork and rhythm, accompanied by the orchestra's exemplary rendition. To have accomplished gurus and a lovely team of musicians is a blessing for any performance. I'd like to first introduce our guru, Guru Shubha Parmar. Guru Shubha Parmar, founder of Shubanjali, is a highly sought-after dancer, teacher, and choreographer in New Jersey. She is the direct disciple of Kalaimamani Guru Indra Rajan and Pandanalur Srinivasa Pillai, respected doyens of the Pandanalur tradition. Guru Shubha is recognized as a pioneer in the arts community, and her original artistic creations like Santa and Shiva, Splash the Wonder, Beauty and the Beast, Lured by the Myths, Oneness, Tribute to the Legends, Tattva Tapas Tejas, Tathastu, among many others, have received rave reviews from critics. She is the recipient of many prestigious awards, including the U.S. Presidential Scholar's Most Influential Teacher Award, presented by the Obama administration, the Bala Saraswati Award of Excellence from the Muttamar Peravai, the New Jersey Natya Kalanidhi, and the most recent Lifetime Achievement Award from Spandana, New Jersey. Her brainchild, Shubanjali, is celebrating its 30th year in the US and will successfully present the 125th graduation in 2023. Next, I have the honor of introducing Guru Swamimalai K. Suresh. He is the director of Samarpana Academy of Fine Arts, Chennai, and artistic director, Shubanjali, New Jersey. He hails from a traditional family of Natuanars and musicians. His father and guru, Pandanalur P. V. Kalidas, is a renowned Nagaswara Vidwan of the Pandanalur lineage. His great-grandfather, Pandanalur Guruswami Pillai, was an Ashtavadani, meaning he could concentrate on 8 different activities at any given time. Guru Suresh is the 5th-generation artist from his family. He's the grand-nephew and disciple of veteran Guru Swamimalai S.K. Rajaratnam, under whom he mastered Bharatanatyam, vocal and natuangam. He's also a senior disciple of violin maestro Sri Lalgudi Ji Jayaraman. Guru Suresh is an accomplished dancer, singer, choreographer, and Natuanar, and is the recipient of several awards, including Kanchi Kamakoti Peetam Astana Vidwan title from Kanchi Shankaracharya, Ustad Bismala Khan Yuva Purskar from Sangeet Natak Academy, and the most recent Service Award from Spandana, New Jersey. Next, we will introduce our vocalist, Burekudi G.R. Praveen. Burekudi G.R. Praveen is a disciple of his grandfather, Kalemamani Sri Burekudi P.V. Ganesha Iyer. He has been singing classical music for the past 15 years. Praveen has participated in many festivals of music and dance, including the Delhi Tamil Sangam, Bombay NCPA, Bharat Kalachar, Mylapore Fine Arts. He has also participated in all the major dance festivals of India and abroad. He has been awarded Isai Kalemani from Coimbatore Government Music College and awarded Nada Gana Kalemani and also Mayura Gana Kalemani from Mayura Natyanjali. Next, I would like to introduce the mridangist, Maya Varam T. Vishwanathan. Mridangam artist M. T. Vishwanathan is one of the most sought-after percussionists among dancers. He has been widely appreciated for his flawless support in music and dance concerts. After graduating from the Tamil Nadu Music College in 1990, he has been receiving advanced training from world-renowned mridangam maestro Guruvayur Durai. He has performed with several leading musicians and dancers of today. He has extensively toured the USA and Europe and conducted workshops in Europe. He has also collaborated with top-ranking jazz artists in France. Next, an introduction of our violinist. Hailing from a family of well-known musicians, Durai Srinivasan is a much-sought-after young violinist from Chennai. He began his musical journey under his father, Sri Durai Swaminathan. His violin journey then continued under various renowned artists, including K. V. Ramanujam and V. V. Srinivasa Rao, AIR artist. Currently, he is under the tutelage of Padma Shri Kalemamani Kumari, A. Kanyakumari. He holds a master's degree in violin from the renowned Tamil Nadu Music and Fine Arts University, and is now a full-time violin artist. He has accompanied various artists in the field of Carnatic music. He has also performed as a freelance artist. Besides giving solo performances, he has toured several countries including the USA, Australia, South Africa, Singapore, Sri Lanka, Reunion Islands, and Canada. He also has a number of awards from various leading sabhas and other cultural organizations to add to his belt. And last but not least, our melodious flautist, Sri Vasant Kumar Vairamanikam. Sri Vasant Kumar Vairamanikam is a renowned classical Carnatic flutist. He has won national and state gold medals in the competitions held by both central and state governments. He has accompanied stalwarts like O.S. Tyagarajan and renowned dancers, and has traveled many times to the USA. Since 2006, he is an assistant professor in the Department of Music of Annamalai University, Chidambaram, Tamil Nadu. He has dedicated his life to this art and has contributed his services as an accompanist in classical music programs. Let's give one more full round of applause to this amazing orchestra. Bindhya's next piece will be a varnam. The varnam is the centerpiece of any Arangetram. Anywhere from 20 to 50 minutes long, this dance often tests the performer's endurance and ability to engage the audience. Today's varnam will be 30 minutes. A varnam can bring varied sentiments, shades and flavors, and paint a mosaic of patterns of abhinaya, which is emotions, and nritta, which is pure dance. In the first half of this varnam, the dancer usually begins with a trikala jati, a jati rendered in three speeds, followed by a line of sahityam or prose. The entire line of sahityam corresponds to one avartanam and is repeated 4 to 6 times. The sahityam is preceded by a jati. Varnam is a term borrowed from Carnatic music. In technical parlance, this dance composition commences with usually 4 and rarely 6 feet of sahitya, each corresponding to one avartanam of the talam. This varnam portrays the bhakti and wholehearted love towards Krishna. The song and dance depicts the pining of a heart for the affection and attention of the Lord. As with every story or connotation in any spirituality, this story is also open to the viewer's interpretation of the symbolic references. The love for this Lord can be seen in this piece. Thank you again for Priya for depicting this beautiful sanchari's, two of which we will show in this piece. The first sanchari illustrates a gopika longing for Krishna as she describes his various traits to her companions. She calls him the one who stole her heart and asks her friend to bring Krishna to her. The gopi describes his glowing, moon-like face, his locks of curly hair, his sindoor, and his beautiful, shining earrings. She demonstrates how he walks with the might of an elephant, how he wears his dhoti, how his body resembles the clouds, and his delicate peacock feather that lies perfectly placed upon his crown. The second sanchari displays another gopika getting ready in hopes of Krishna coming to her house. She washes her floors, puts kolam or rangoli, and hangs flower garlands all around the house to decorate it for his arrival. She then selects an outfit for herself and prepares herself in front of the mirror that she sets up, applies kajal, then her earrings and her bindi, waiting in anticipation for him, only to realize that Krishna has not arrived. This varnam will also describe Krishna lifting Mount Govardhana to protect the villagers of Vrindavan from the rain. It shows Krishna dancing on top of Kaliya, the snake sent to kill him. It depicts ending the evil of Kamsa, his uncle. It reveals the benevolence of Krishna helping his friend Kuchela through tough times. It shows baby Krishna eating mud and showing the universe in his open mouth. It depicts Krishna tied with a rope as he crawls away from captivity. The dance shows Krishna helping Draupadi when Dushasana attempted to remove her sari. And finally, Krishna's iconic flute playing that enchanted all of Vrindavan and hopefully you too. Perform this varnam in Adi Talam. The varnam is the central piece of the Bharatanatyam repertoire. This varnam centers around Krishna and his childhood antics. It alternates between jatis or swarams, pure nitra pieces, and stories told through abhinayas or emotions, including a story of Kuchela, Draupadi, and Krishna showing the seven worlds after eating mud. Please enjoy this varnam.
சுல்லடி சக்தியே
Thank you. ta ding ginnatum ta ding ginnat ta ding ginnatum ta ding ginnat tomta, ding in a tomta, ding in a tomta, ding in a tomta, ding in a tomta.
Mayanga, Bindhya Bye.
What a beautiful Varnam by Bindhya. Let's hear it one more time for her. You'll now get a chance to see a small slideshow depicting Bindhya's Bharatanatyam experience and dance experience over her entire life. Please enjoy. Perfect, okay. What a beautiful slideshow and truly a testament to her passion for dance over these past few years. Her stamina and dedication has shown through each of the steps in all of her performance so far. Now, we will proceed with a kirtanam. A kirtanam means a chant in the name of a deity. This kirtanam is on Muruga, Arubade Vidamaranda, composed by Sri M.P. Shivan in Aditalam in Ragamalika. This song describes Lord Muruga's story as he resides in six different homes throughout Tamil Nadu. Tiruparan Kundram, this is celebrating Muruga's marriage to Devayani. Tirutani, Muruga kills an asura or evil being named Surupadman. Swamimalai, the temple commemorates the incident where Muruga is regarded to have explained the essence of the mantram Om to his father Shiva. Tiruchendur, Murugan is said to have reclaimed his inner peace after waging a war with the asuras and married Valli here. Parani, Muruga has a feud with his parents over a mango and leaves home with nothing and picks Parani as his home. Paramuddir Chole, Murugan is seen here with both his consorts, Devayani and Valli. Please enjoy this kirtanam.
Yeah. வேட்டை மான் தேடிய வேடவனே, வேட்டை மான் தேடிய
What an enchanting performance bringing the abodes of Murga to the stage. Let's hear one more round of applause for that. Today, the gurus and the orchestra have made this extra special with their choreography and flawless singing. We would now like to felicitate the guru, the orchestra, and all the amazing help today. First, I'd like to call to the stage Guru Shubha Parmar. I'd also like to call to the stage Guru Swamimalai K. Suresh. Next, I'd like to call the orchestra to the stage, starting with vocalist G.R. Praveen. I'd like to call the rest of the orchestra as well, Mridangist Mayavaram T. Vishwanathan. Violinist Durai Srinivasan. And flutist Vasant Kumar Vairamanikam. Let's hear one more round of applause for the full orchestra and gurus for their amazing help today. Next, I'd like to introduce a few amazing backstage members who are all critical to this performance. First, Ms. Renu Kurian, the makeup artist. Bindhya would next like to give a shout out to photography and videography by Justin Indus Photography. As well as to the MCC staff, Chris, Henry, and Rob, thank you all for your hard work today. And finally, thank you for helping us up in the lighting boxes, Gia.
I would like to thank our MC today, Divya, and supported by Priya.
I would like to ask you guys to give one more big round of applause to all of the backstage help, the gurus and the orchestra for their amazing help and performances today. Next, I'd like to call a few of Bindhya's family and close friends up to the stage to say a few words about the dancer. The first speaker will be Tarun Parthasarathy, Bindhya's brother.
Hi, I'm Bindhya's brother, Tarun. I would like to start this speech off by stating that Bindhya is very hardworking, persistent, and dedicated. My first memories of Bindhya's dancing career was driving half an hour and sitting in the corner of the dance studio. I was watching as my mom and sister would dance. After that, we'd go to Trader Joe's and Dunkin' Donuts. Even after we moved to California, she stayed focused, continuing Bharatanatyam online. This dance performance is not just 3 hours, but an encapsulation of over a decade of practice. I wish her the best of luck in her future endeavors and the rest of the performance.
Thank you so much to Tarun for that speech. I'd next like to call Hansika and Karishma Subramanian, Bindhya's lifelong friends from preschool.
Hello everyone, my name is Hansika.
And my name is Karishma.
And we have had the honor of knowing Bindhu since we were 4 years old. We remember the day we met in the playground at Nero Montessori School like it was yesterday. We were all way too shy to play in the red light, green light game that was going on, so we all took refuge in the pink playhouse of the corner of the playground. At first, we all just stood there and stared at each other, but we soon realized that we were staring at who would be our lifelong best friend. We immediately hit it off and would always play together. Little did we know that our friendship would grow even more from there. The three of us joined Mona Auntie's dance class when we were 5. During playdates, we would play the game Mona Auntie's dance class. We remember taking turns on who got to be Mona Auntie using the imaginary nut Tavangan. We also remember the many memories in the dance dojo of us eating random snacks together while we waited for our mom's classes to be over. One of our favorite memories together was our very first dance performance, where we wore red and green outfits. We were all so excited to do our dance makeup and take pictures in every Bharatanatyam pose you could think of. Looking back, every picture our moms have taken of us makes it seem as though we were all triplets because of how close we were. For those of you that don't know Bindhya, there are so many words that best describe her. Bindhya is humble, caring, compassionate, smart, loyal, and as you all have seen, very, very talented. Anytime she's over at our house, she always offers to help with the dishes, clean our rooms, serve food, and really anything a guest should not be doing. This past week when she stayed with us, even after her long 5-hour practices, she would come over to our house and would refuse to eat unless we were eating with her. We will always cherish the simple memories also, like watching Cobra Kai and judging every character and saying, Bharatanatyam is so much more difficult than karate, and claiming how easily we could land a flying tornado kick, but even though we would land on our faces, all three of us. It is memories like this that Hansi and I will cherish for the rest of our lives, and we hope you do too, Bindhu. Bindhya, you are truly one of a kind, and we are so lucky to have such a special person in our lives.
Bindhya, you have worked beyond hard for this day with a beautiful smile on your face. Watching you today makes us feel so proud because you have proven to everyone that you can do anything with hard work and perseverance. Wherever you are backstage, Bindhu, know how much we love and care about you. Also know that you're truly the triplet we've always wanted. Please enjoy the rest of the program.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Hansika and Karishma, for that beautiful speech. Finally, I'd like to call Biju Mama and Priya Aunty, Bindhya's family friends, who have known Bindhya from when she first moved to the U.S.
Good evening, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank Lakshmi and Partha, right? They have not just been friends, but are family to us and have touched our lives in many ways. So thank you. I have still not understood, but why they, you know, moved to California, right? Who would leave behind the friend circle and family that you see in this auditorium today, the great garden state of New Jersey, and go to smoky California? Now, by saying that, I bear no ill feelings to residents of California. Now, today is not about that. It's about celebrating Bindhya, right? The girl whom we have seen grow up right from the age of one to the fine young lady that she is today. She has always shown the zeal and passion to achieve what she set out to do, right? Not her in the field of studies, but in whatever activities she has touched, she has not just excelled, but created a zone of her own. And it gives us immense pleasure to see that she is performing here today in front of all of us and have mastered a complex art of Bharatanatyam, which shows that with her dedication and hard work that she puts into when she sets her mind, she can achieve even greater heights. I should also thank the teachers who have made actually this possible, the eminent group of musicians who are here today, who have helped realize this dream of Bindhya. To us also, this occasion marks her graduation to the next phase of life, a life that is filled with opportunities and the experiences of which will eventually mold her to be the person that she will become. At this stage, we wish her the very best. We are with you, Bindhya, in whatever we do. You make us immensely proud, and I am sure with your focus and dedication, you are just starting to climb the ladder of success. Love you, not just from me, but Priyandi and Anushka as well. Bye.
Thank you so much to all of you for your moving speeches about our beautiful dancer. During this next short intermission, you'll hear the melodious orchestra and vocalist perform another song.
Ta-ra-ra-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na- குறையொன்றும் இல்லை மறைமூர்த்தி கண்ணா, குறையொன்றும் இல்லை கண்ணா, குறையொன்றும் இல்லை கோவிந்தா, குறையொன்றும் இல்லை மறைமூர்த்தி கண்ணா,
வேண்டியதை வேண்டியதில்
Song and a truly mesmerizing song rendered by this flawless team of vocalists and orchestra. This next piece will be a kirtanam, Yarukum Adangada Neeli, composed by Sri Harikesanallur Muttaya Bhagavadar in Talam Adi and Ragam Abogi. This song is about Kali, the goddess that cannot be subdued by anyone, who protects all from the evils of the world. This song features Kali slaying a demon, representing the death of evil characteristics within ourselves. Neeli refers to Goddess Parvati, or Kali, she who has controlled Parabrahmam in this earth. The illusion, who cannot be understood even by those who study the Vedas. She is the better half of Lord Shiva, and she takes half of his body. She sees the different incarnations of Lord Narayana. She blames Brahma's beheading on fate, and she also protects the composer of this song, Harikesanallur Muttaya Bhagavadar. Please enjoy this kirtanam.
Yarukum Adangada Neeli
takatam dinding ko tattam takita takatam dinding ko tattam kadak ding ko tattam dinding ko takading ko nakading ko kadak ding dinding ko kadak kari kadum tam dinding ko kadak kari kadum tam dinding ko kadak kari kadum tam
yaar madangada neeli
Thank you. gama gama da gari gari sa gari sa gama gari sa da sa sari sa da ma da da sa da ma gama gama gari ga sa gari sa ri sa da sa da ma da ma gari sa ri sa da sa da ma da ma ma da sa di ga ti sa sa ga ti sa ma da ga ti sa ga ri sa da ma ga ti sa da ma gari sa da ma ri sa da ma gama da ma gari ga ma ga ma da sa ga ma
to offer this item as a tribute to my gurus, Kalimamani Indra Rajan and Guru Pandalanur Srinivasapil. The first anniversary of her passing away is this year, so I feel it a great honor to dedicate this item in her memory. Yeah, thank you.
That was such an energetic and now meaningful performance by Bindhya. She brought out the characteristics of Kali with those beautiful expressions and gestures, and she has displayed great agility and grace through her poses and that beautiful split at the end there. Let's give her one more big round of applause for this. We move now forward to the graduation part of this. It is said that the term guru, or teacher, literally means one who dispels the darkness of ignorance and leads the disciple towards the light of knowledge. We can see these traits in abundance in our gurus. The celebrated and loved dance teachers, choreographers, and performers, Srimati Shubha Parmar and Sri Swamimalai Sri Kalidas, Sri Suresh Kalidas. She founded Shubha Parmar founded Shubanjali in 1992 to bring people in contact with the creativity of Indian classical and folk dances of India, along with traditional Carnatic music with theater, thereby making the Indian art forms an important cultural force within the US performing arts scene. Shubanjali is not just a dance school, but also a well-conceived methodology, whereby the unique curriculum allows the student to develop a thorough understanding of the art through the systematic study and technique, culture, and representation of Indian classical music and dance to a global audience. It allows the younger generation of Indian Americans to be exposed to the rich culture and traditions of their homeland. At the same time, it brings about a greater understanding of the Indian culture to the American audiences. We would now like to call upon our esteemed gurus, Shubha Parmar and Sri Swamimalai K. Suresh, to say a few words about Bindhya.
Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. What a delightful performance, Bindhya. You dreamt, you believed, you strived, and you achieved. Congratulations on your superb performance and best wishes and blessings to you for many more years of happiness and continued learning. Bindhya is a very dedicated student. Her determination to excel in this art form is truly commendable. Despite their move to California 6 years ago, her sheer determination and willpower made her learn all the items remotely via Zoom. And this summer, she truly did Gurukulavasam in New Jersey and successfully completed her Bharatanatyam debut with the help of all her former family friends in New Jersey. Preparing for an Arangetram is an amazing journey. It introduces various levels of experiences to help you transform into a magnificent being. The key is to allow these experiences to transform you. A beautiful story comes to my mind. A man found a cocoon of a butterfly. One day, a small opening appeared. He sat and watched the butterfly for several hours, and it had struggled to force its body through the tiny hole. Then it seemed to stop making progress. So the man decided to help the butterfly. He took a pair of scissors and snipped off the remaining bit of the cocoon. The butterfly then emerged easily, but it had a swollen body and small shriveled wings. The man continued to watch the butterfly because he expected that at any moment the wings would enlarge and expand to support the whole body. Neither happened. In fact, the butterfly spent the rest of the life crawling around with a swollen body and shriveled wings. It never was able to fly. What the man, in his kindness and haste, did not understand was that the restricting cocoon and the struggle required for the butterfly to get through the tiny opening were God's way of forcing fluid from the body of the butterfly into its wings so that it would be ready for flight once it achieved its freedom from the cocoon. Sometimes struggles are exactly what we need in our lives. If God allowed us to go through our lives without any obstacles, it would cripple us. We would not be as strong as what we could have been. We could never fly. I asked for strength, and God gave me difficulties to make me strong. I asked for wisdom, and God gave me problems to solve. I asked for prosperity, and God gave me brain and brawn to work. I asked for courage, and God gave me dangers to overcome. I asked for love, and God gave me troubled people to help. And I asked for favors, and God gave me opportunities. I received nothing I wanted, but I received everything I needed. I'm sure, Bindhya, you have captured a glimpse of that joy today with all the hard work and perseverance you put into today's show. You have achieved a tremendous milestone in learning this art, and it's no easy task to stand before an audience for 2.5 hours demonstrating such high level of stamina. This has taken her, like, she, of course, she is a great runner. She has built that willpower to nurture her body to this level of excellence. But her perseverance this last 1 month, where she repeatedly did her repertoire every day for the last 1 month, is what the output you saw today. As I always tell you, Bindhya, the joy is in the effort and in the process, and the fruits are merely for you to enjoy. My sincere thanks to Lakshmi, Partha, and my beautifully haired Tarun. you make all the girls very jealous for giving us the joy of teaching Bindhya. They are very blessed parents who have given a great platform for their children to grow and flourish, and have greatly supported Shubanjali in all its activities. My heart is truly touched by their love and affection. Thank you very much. A great big thank you to our wonderful team of musicians. It is always a joy working with this team, and they are undoubtedly the best. Praveen sir, Visu sir, Vasant and Chinu, your love and commitment for this art is deeply appreciated by all of us. Thank you. And to our dear Suresh sir, for all your unconditional love and training the students, and your melodious singing and the other incredible set of talents you possess. Right? He's not only a Dashavadani, but more than that. A big round of applause to our team of musicians. My special thanks goes to my family, my mom, my husband, my daughter, and to the rest of my family who are here for 30 years of unconditional support in my journey as a dancer and a teacher. It's not easy dealing with me. Thank you so much for putting up with me. On this very special day, with the blessings of all the elders gathered here and blessings of all our gurus, Suresh sir and myself, we're very honored to present this award of graduation to our dear Bindhya and blessing her for a bright future and take this art and be an inspiration to the world. Shubanjali School of Performing Arts, New Jersey, USA, presents the title of Shubanjali Natya Dhruma Pallava to Bindhya Parthasarathy for her outstanding performance and the successful completion of a Bharatanatyam Arangetram, 5th August 2023, at the Middlesex County College, Edison, New Jersey, presented by Guru Suba Parmar and Guru Swamimalai Suresh. If Mona Aunty is here, please join us, Mona Aunty. She left? Okay. Has successfully become the 122nd graduate of Shubanjali.
What an absolutely beautiful thing to witness. After years of dedicated practice and training, Bindhya's graduation marks a celebration of her efforts. I'm sure this is an amazing moment and feeling for Bindhya. I can even imagine Bindhya's excitement after this year of anticipation leading up to this day. 4 years ago this same month, I had my own Arangetram graduation under Shubha Parmar. I'm excited for Bindhya to join the alumni group. Our star of the evening now, Bindhya, is a 16-year-old incoming junior at Homestead High School. Her interests include cross-country running, Model UN, and of course, Bharatanatyam. She joined Shubanjali and started learning under the guidance of Shubha Aunty and Mona Aunty at the age of 6, and Suresh sir at the age of 10. I'd now like to call her up to say a few words about her own experience.
Hi, I'm Bindhya, and I would first like to thank all of you for coming and supporting me today. My dance journey first began when I was 5 years old with Shubanjali, with my two best friends, Hansi and Karish. I have known them since we met in the doll playhouse in preschool, and we have been friends since. When we joined dance, I still remember that Mona Aunty had to pick up and move our little feet because we did not know how to do that ourselves. I'm extremely lucky to have such supportive, sweet, and funny friends. I truly would not be here on this stage if I did not watch their Arangetram and realize that I belonged at Shubanjali. Dance has taught me so much, and it also serves as a good reminder that I need to slow down. Both Auntie and Sir can both tell you that I tend to rush through things sometimes, namely the second half of my varna. I would not be the person or dancer I am today without my amazing gurus. Suba Auntie told me on the way to my photo shoot that the most important thing to follow is to get inspired and inspire others. Suba Auntie, thank you for your constant inspiration for the past 11 years through your kindness, thoughtfulness, and energy. Thank you for making me feel welcome and supported this summer. You've taught me so much more than just dance. Suresh sir, thank you for giving me the opportunity to learn from you. I know you sacrificed some sleep to wake up early and teach classes, and I'm really grateful. From dancing to playing tag and to your avatar face, this whole summer has been filled with fun memories. I'm gonna miss you and Auntie so much. I've enjoyed the Arangetram experience so much, I wish I could go back and relive it. To the musicians, thank you for making this week so fun and lively and being part of today's performance. To my 2023 Arangetram girls, thank you so much for making this Arangetram experience a memory I will treasure forever. I will miss all of you so much, from cheering each other on while we were doing our songs, talking and staying up way too late at the sleepover, and even when we couldn't sleep because Anika decided that the light fixture was a man in the ceiling at 3 in the morning. Most importantly, I want to thank my mom. Amma, thank you for being my number one cheerleader for the past 16 years. From being my makeup artist for my dance performances, giving me pep talks, for organizing an Arangetram from across the country, the list goes on and on. Your creativity, patience, and care has made me feel so lucky to have a mother like you. I truly do not know what I would do without you, and I love you so much. I also could not have done this without the support of my dad and my brother. Daddy, thank you for massaging my feet, scooping my ice cream, and for being the official photographer and videographer for all my previous performances. The videos are mainly of my feet, but at least he tried. Tarun, I did not realize when Amma and I spent the summer in New Jersey that I would miss you the most. Even if you're always solving the Rubik's Cube and bombarding me with random riddles you found on YouTube, you're the best brother I could ask for. For the amount of dance classes that you have sat through, I'm confident that you know the mudras by heart. Lastly, thank you all again for coming, and I hope you enjoyed the performance.
What an amazing chance to hear from Bindhya herself. We will now get to the concluding part of the Arangetram, which is the Tilana. The lively climax of the Arangetram exhibits exuberance of rhythm with sculpted poses and pure dance, bringing out the ecstasy of human spirits by technical purity and vitality to convey a feeling of supreme bliss with rhythmic patterns. This Tilana is in Ragam Revati and Talam Adi, composed by Sri Madurai N. Krishnan. This Tilana ends with a short lyrical section in praise of Goddess Devi. Please enjoy.
Thank you. tadim dim tadim tadirana
Thank you.
Such a delight to see Bindhya up on the stage so far with her excellent expressions and poise throughout this afternoon and especially in that climactic piece. I'd now like to call to the stage Lakshmi Aunty and Partha Uncle, Bindhya's parents, for a vote of thanks.
We stand here obviously as proud parents, amazed by what Bindhya could achieve and perform today. And of course, I think typically a word of thanks is for people coming in and we thank them, but I want to start somewhere else. I want to first thank Bindhya. The reason is because 11 years back, I did not have any appreciation for art. But for Bindhya, I wouldn't have had an opportunity to appreciate art. So I want to thank first Bindhya for being very focused, and she is the first in our family to do anything on this scale, and I think probably it's going to, many more are going to follow, but she is the first, and we want to thank Bindhya for what she has done and helped us appreciate this art in a more detailed form and fashion. This is 11 years story. And as I look back from where we started, and as Bindhya mentioned, Mona Aunty would literally put her feet and then say, keep this foot here. In her comments, still I remember in Vidyapeeth, she would say, your foot is just less than my palm. And from there, now she is here performing an Arangetram for 2 hours, just looking at the magnanimous, the amount of detail, facial expressions and movements. It's amazing. I'm sure you also appreciate that. And I think, she's done a really wonderful job, and we are obviously proud as parents, right? But coming to the main point, today's event would not have been possible without Shubanjali. Shubanjali, yep. I think many of you know how Shubanjali works, but we got to really feel the Shubanjali family, not just in words, but in action. And we really want to thank the Shubanjali School for giving us this experience and opportunity, right? As Lakshmi mentioned, we are out of honors as of date, right? But then we never felt in the past 1 month that we are out of honors. First, of course, Guru Shubha Parmar and Guru Swamimalai Kalidas, Suresh Kalidas, sorry. The way of amount of time and dedication that they put in into Bindhya for the past 1 month, getting her prepared to where she is today, that's amazing, and thank you. Thank you for opening up your hearts and your home for us, In fact, when me and Lakshmi first discussed about having a Bharatanatyam Arangetram here, my first question was, hey, you know, all the students normally talk about their experience of how they spend with Shubha Aunty and what they learn in that process. How is Bindhya going to get all that? You know what? It happened. She still was able to spend time with the gurus, get all the learning that surround the Bharatanatyam, and now standing here, I think that's true manifestation, right? Thank you. Thanks, everybody. Coming to the other part, as Shubha Parmar mentioned, you know, Mr. Ramesh Parmar and Gomati Mami. What an amazing family. I think many of you have felt it, have touched it. You know, it's amazing the amount of support and the true love that they shower on people. You know, it's an example for all of us to learn and take it forward to the rest of the world. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Ramesh Parmar. Thank you, Gomati Mami. Coming to the orchestra, you know, this is my first time interacting with musicians in, you know, such close quarters. As I have told you, I had zero appreciation of you know, art before Bindhya started learning. What an amazing set of people. You know, I really want to thank each one of you for having, you know, adjusted, you know, understood how Bindhya is performing and do all the rehearsals with her, making her, you know, perform to her best. I know at the end of the day, it's all about making sure you create the arena for a performance, which is, you know, to their you know, capability and you know, experience, right? So thank you, all of you, right? Thank you. Now, coming to the other part, right? We could not have done this without our NJ friends and family. That's a true extended family for us. I know. I cannot just name one or two people because the limit and the list is going to be endless, or probably it's pretty much, I have to call out everybody here sitting here in this auditorium. We could not have done this. Thanks each one of you for you know, for having looked at Bindhya, you know, enjoyed her growth, and now right here, being here to appreciate what she has achieved. A big thank you from our family to each one of you for the love and affection that you have shown to us, not just now, but even in the past. But really, thanks each one of you for helping us do this function out here in New Jersey.
Yeah, I was mentioning to Suba Aunty that our guests are indeed the host as well, right? Many of you here helped for decorating the fire, the stage, with the food and everything. I didn't do much. So that is an amazing audience that we have today in Friends in New Jersey here.
Thank you again, each one of you, for making this occasion memorable for us, for Bindhya, and for everybody. I think we're going to cherish this for forever. Really appreciate each one of you taking time out to come and, you know, sit here and enjoy and appreciate. And also want to thank the Bindhya's, this year's Arangetram group, for being the cheerleaders for her all through and spending time. Thanks, everybody.
This has been such an amazing day getting us to this concluding dance piece. The concluding dance of a performance is an offering of prayers to the divine. A mangalam is a concluding piece of a recital offering thanks to the gurus and to the audience. This mangalam is in praise of Lord Krishna and describes various stories from his childhood, including his dance on the snake in the banks of the river Yamuna and playing with the gopikas. We invite all of our guests to join us for a dinner reception after this performance. Thank you all so much for coming. Please enjoy her mangalam, Krishna Mukunda Murare in Talam Adi, composed by Sri Papanasan Sivan.
Thank you. Krishna Mukunda Murare. Yeah.